I love the kazoo concerto. It's so fun, and we talked about all the different composers that we have in there, and they're very familiar with Ode to Joy because they're going to be playing that for recorder, for their black belt in recorder karate. So we're pretty excited about that. Our next song is a traditional folk song. And this is actually extra special to me because in the summers currently I'm taking grad school classes in Hartford, Connecticut, and I'm getting my master's with a folk song research background. And so The Water is Wide is actually a folk song that's been cataloged so many times, and the kids just do such a great job performing it. So please enjoy The Water is Wide. So let's move on to the next song. Anyway, our next song is called Amani Utupe. It's part in English and part in Swahili, and it means grant us peace, give us courage.
We need strength to carry on our load. Amani Utupe, now stop.
for you, please give it up for Mrs. Melanie Burns on the piano. It's so fantastic to work with, I love it. It's great. Our last song today is something that's super special to all of us, and I actually had one of my friends from college actually did an arrangement for us. And this is a well-known song sung by Sarah Bareilles. The title is Brave. And before we sing, I would like to share a little poem with you about bravery, and we talked about this with the chorus. The title is Misconception by Rachel Cloud. Bravery isn't about foolhardy acts of honor. It's admitting you're afraid and still having the moral compass to do what's right. And I think that every single one of these kids behind me is going to face something in their life where they're going to have to stand up and be brave. And so I just hope that when they get to middle school, they keep this in mind. Without further ado, can I please invite down my soloists, Brian D., Brianna Lucinski, Julia Medivier, and Megan Dexter.
What you wanna say, and let the words fall out. when I was at the house with dinner one time a few months ago. His elbow, yeah.
No, well, we don't know, it could be, but he has a blood clot here.
Here.
A little in
the
mouth.
When did you go to
the
hospital?
We went to the hospital, yes, last time.
What vitamins that go down? Like just pain? Or discomfort?
I'm leaving. Rich, are you getting her?
Yeah.
I think it has. Watch out for all this stuff.
starts.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was Yankee Spirit March, a little patriotic medley there with some of the military tunes and Yankee Doodle and America the Beautiful. Next, we're going to perform Attack of the Garden Gnomes. And the story behind this is Timothy Lost wrote in his program notes here that he was inspired to write this thinking about a prank he read about in the 80s where people would kidnap a garden gnome out of somebody's garden and literally take it to different parts of the world, traveling with them and take pictures and send it back to the people they took it from. So you know, have a gnome with the Eiffel Tower and a gnome with the pyramids of Giza and all this stuff. So he said, well, that's great, but what if the garden gnomes decide to fight back instead of being kidnapped? So this is the musical story of what happens when those garden gnomes get even with us. Song Ghost Lights is actually classified as a contemporary piece of music, and you're going to hear some harmonies in here that you're not really used to. And just to kind of demonstrate, so you don't think we're playing wrong notes, you guys are used to hearing things like stuff like, oh, thank you. Just kidding, Robin. Okay, but in this song, you're gonna hear more the flutes and clarinets doing things like this. Sounds like a car horn. Things like that. So they are the correct notes, but it was kind of a neat teaching piece because the students are playing harmonies and notes against each other that they don't normally hear in pop music or in our regular band music. So that's what kind of makes it in the contemporary style. And we also have a special effect in here, and I'm gonna surprise our lighting technician, Robin Eichler. Hi, Robin. Robin, I need your help with this because, you know, we don't have a dress rehearsal because we're in a different building. So, in the middle of this song, I'm going to turn around and I'm going to give you a cue like that. Do you think you'd give me 40% stage lights at that point? Okay. Is that a yes? And then, when I do that, can I get 100% back? Wonderful. Okay. So, we love experimenting on the night of a concert. Please enjoy Ghost Lights. Thank you, Mrs. Eichler. That went well. I'm glad we practiced that. Creative art right before your eyes, folks. That piece was especially challenging just because it's a certain collection of notes and fingerings we learned the first year. It's pretty universal, you know, across the country. And for that one, we had to learn about five or six extra ones beyond what we normally learn to play all those. For any of these musical people out there, we had all kinds of sharps and flats that we normally don't learn the first year. So they worked really hard on that. It was a lot of work. Our last piece, we're going to close with The Lost Tomb. And this is kind of more of what the kids like, fast and loud. Anybody who's been to any of my concerts before know we have the fast and loud piece in there. And it is inspired by historical fiction authors such as like Clive Cussler, who likes to weave fiction stories with real history facts, okay? So this is to depict going in and doing some tomb raiding or tomb exploring. This is The Lost Tomb.
Thank you. Thank you.